tried it. I probably love it, from hiking to skiing to fishing. And yes, I did catch that 145-pound halibut by myself. Horseback riding, but you name it, I love it. But there was a point where I was not so much of an outdoor enthusiast. There was a point in time where I'd never hiked more than 5 miles. And what that made me realize is that there's a beginning for everything and for everyone. And so my friend calls me up one day and he says, "Keichun, for my birthday, I want to go to Yosemite National Park and I want to climb Half Dome. Has anyone been to Yosemite or climbed Half Dome?" Okay, oh, you have, okay, so you know. Let me tell you, I have to reiterate, I had never hiked more than 5 miles. So he calls me, he says, "Keichun, by the way, don't do any research. Just trust me, and it's going to be epic." So I say, "All right, I won't do research, even though you're making me nervous. I trust you, and I believe it's going to be epic." Go to the next slide. And so this is the research that I did not do about Half Dome. So it is a 19-mile hike. It has about 12,000 feet of elevation. The last part, you actually have to enter into a lottery. They only allow 50 people to climb the last part every day. And it adds another 1,500 feet of elevation for that last part, which, by the way, is a cable route that runs all the way from the valley to the tip top of the mountain. On the website, it actually had a difficulty level of extreme. And it's quoted, "It's long and steep at the beginning of an end and more dangerous and difficult of all Yosemite day hikes. On the scale of 1 to 10, this one rates an 11. Mind you, I didn't do this research. And then something I had never seen in my 5 miles of hiking was an insanity factor. There was an insanity factor! And the website says, "The insanity factor is a 9 out of 10. And the website is quoted, "Wait till you get to the cables and you'll see." Mind you, I'd never hiked more than 5 miles. And I didn't do this research. You can go to the next slide. And so we're going and we're hiking and I'm with my friend and his friend and we're like, "Oh my gosh, we are at Yosemite. Like, we are really doing this." And this picture, what you see, is when we had about halfway to Half Dome. So this is just over 5 miles. And at this moment, I realized, oh my gosh, this is the most that I've ever hiked in my entire life. Each new step was going to be my new personal record. Each new step, I was like, "Oh yeah, I'm better, I'm stronger, I'm confident." And I was like holding my shoulders back and I'm like, "Come on guys, I'm leading the pack." It wasn't even moments later that I looked up and I said, "Wait, whoa, wait, wait a minute, wait a minute. That's where we're going? That's the mountain that we're climbing? And it's 19 miles? And, oh my gosh." And that's immediately when the voices, the negative thoughts, the self-doubt began to creep in. "You didn't prepare for this. You're not a hiker. You're not even an outdoor person at this point. You've never hiked more than 5 miles before. What do you think you're doing trying to do this?" And that's also immediately when I had to begin to rely on my team, the person who believed in me. That's also the moment when I really had to take a look around. I am in one of the most beautiful national parks on this earth. I had to take the moment and look at the granite rock and the rock formations and the weeds and the flowers that were bloomed just ever so pretty and the wildlife that was around me and the waterfalls and how the sun would hit the water just perfect enough to make a beautiful rainbow appear. I had to focus on those. I couldn't focus on this guy who passed me. I couldn't focus on these guys who passed me. I could only focus on myself and the fact that with each new step, I was getting better. And it was my new personal record. And I was actually doing this. And then we got to the cable route. And immediately,
oh my God,
those voices began to creep right back up in my mind. They're like, "Are you kidding me, Keichun? Let me paint this picture for you. Let me just help you understand this cable route." Okay, so it's another 1,500 feet of elevation. This is a granite rock mountain, and it's about a 45-degree angle. The cable route has about, it's about 5 feet wide, and this is for traffic going up and traffic going down. It's also, so the cable is woven through these metal poles that are, oh, go back one, sorry. The cable is woven through these metal poles that are put into the granite rock by, I don't even know what, they're kind of shaking and wobbling. And I am absolutely terrified. And I have my friend in front of me, I have his friend behind me, and we are going. I have no other choice. I've gotten this far, let's do this. And so I'm pulling myself literally up this 45 degree angle, and I'm like, okay, my friend's in front of me. He's like, Keichun, we have 100 more feet. We have 70 more feet, 80 more feet. You got this, we're almost there. His friend's behind me like, go, go, move your butt, hurry up. Because if you let go, you probably would not live to tell the story. So I got over that fear and I made it to the top. Kevin, you missed your cue. No, what happened? Go back. One more. Okay, so I made it to the top. And even though this is an individual shot, let me tell you that this was absolutely, positively a team effort to get there. I had to believe in my team who told me, Keichun, trust me, you got this. I believe in you. I had to really pay attention to my scenery and not focus on the top of the mountain. That's actually what made that hike fun. That's actually what made me fall in love with hiking. I now thoroughly enjoy doing 20-mile hikes, thoroughly. And then as soon as I got finished basking in that scenery, it was time for my next summit. How the heck am I gonna get down? But I got down. And so I think that there's many things that you can take away and apply to your life as you're working towards achieving your goals in this business, as you're working towards living a healthy, fulfilling life. You can go to the next slide, Kevin. But what I want to focus on in this story is how to reach your summit. Reaching your summit. So right now in your notebook, I would like for everyone to write down your BHAG. Does everyone know what the BHAG is?
Yes.
Your big, hairy, audacious goal. And now let me tell you something. It doesn't have to be Beachbody related. For my guests, maybe it's weight loss, maybe it's weight gain, maybe it's wearing that dress that you never wear. Whatever it is though, I want you to write it down right now. I don't want you to be nervous or fearful about setting BHAGs because maybe you set one before and you didn't hit it. Or maybe that puts pressure on you. Take the pressure off. It's important for you to set those BHAGs, set those audacious goals, because it's about the person you become. That's what it's about. It's not about the attainment. Of course, let's attain it. But it truly is about who you become in the pursuit of achieving that BHAG. Does everybody have theirs written down? So as you begin to climb the mountain towards reaching that summit, towards reaching that BHAG, you will begin to see the belief in who you are and what you can accomplish shift mentally in your mind, because you are walking towards your BHAG, towards your summit. You, with every step, are getting better and getting stronger and getting more confident, just like I was on that mountain. So we went to summit. I saw lots of hands. We're here at Super Saturday. We're about to watch this amazing video if you weren't at Summit. But one thing I took from Summit is that our future is oh so bright. I mean, from now and through the beginning of next year, we've already kind of given you a glimpse of the opportunity that's available with Beachbody, the opportunity and the resources that are new and available for you guys. But it doesn't matter unless you take advantage of it. You have to maximize this moment right now. And that's something that only you can do. You have to take advantage of it. You know what your goals are. You know your vision. You are the only one who knows how bad you want it and how hard you're willing to work for it. Only you. And there's a lot of yous there, but here's the stark reality. No one can do it for you. And no one can do it like you. It's up to you. And that's a good thing, guys. Because of that, that's what's going to make you stronger, you better, and you will have helped people in the pursuit of it. So maximize your walk, your climb towards that summit using things like Team Cup. Who is on a Team Cup team? Love it. Okay, so let me tell you that I stayed up so late. I don't even know how late I stayed up watching the opening ceremony to the Olympics. Anyone else? so cool. I mean, their show was ridiculous, right? But one thing that kind of like it reignited my competitiveness was Team Cup with the Olympics. So I'm talking to my coaches really quick. Guys, let's bring home the cup. I mean, we have so many amazing programs available at a discounted rate this month. Why not bring the cup home? I am tired of the Canadians taking it back to Canada. We can do this. Let's bring the cup back home. But like I mentioned, we have some of our most popular challenge packs at a discounted rate. There's no reason for you not to be able to help someone out there. The help that we are literally giving away $1 million by you committing to a program and tracking it in the Challenge Tracker app. And again, we have amazing new programs like 3-week yoga retreat, J&J Core to Four, to the next slide. But again, it doesn't matter unless you maximize this moment. It's up to you. And so now what? Oh my gosh, we're in a whirlwind. Summit, Super Saturday, so much information. What do you do with it? Well, the first thing is, you gotta digest it. You gotta take time to go back through your notes. I am one who I actually need to rewrite my notes because in the thick of things, I'm just kind of scribbling all over the place. And so I like to get them and I like to organize them. That way I know I can see what may be conducive to me and my culture and on my team. And so if it fits in with who you are wanting to become and your team culture, try it. Go ahead and try it. Give it some time. See if it works. Try it. But that does not mean to chase after every shiny object. So what that means is all the tips that you got from every single workshop at Summit, don't do all of them, guys. Pick one, maybe two, to try. Don't chase after every shiny object. It's not about, and have fun. Have fun with fitness. If you get up in the morning and you're not having fun, you're doing something wrong. Have fun with this. Go to the next slide. All right, so back to this climbing your mountain. I mentioned some resources that you can use as you climb your mountain, but your BHAG is right there on the top. Leave it there. Leave it right there. And the way that you get to the top of that is by focusing one step at a time. So those one steps are your inviting. I challenge everyone to invite 3 people this month. I challenge you all to help 3 people with one of these amazing challenge packs that we have for sale this month. This month, 3 people. Invite. That's one sure way that you will begin to climb your mountain towards your BHAG. Be improved, the product works. Who right now is doing a program or about to start? I want to see a raise of hands. Woo. Boom, shakalaka. That's what I'm talking about. I myself am starting Country Heat on Monday. So if you haven't started a program, get on one. Be proof the product works. Why? Because it gives you confidence. It gives you credibility. It gives you the know-how to say, no, this is going to work for you. I can tell you because it worked for me. Personal development, that's so important, guys. So important. But I want to challenge you. Don't just read personal development. Don't just read or listen to something because someone told you to. Go find something that is what you need at this very moment. And then just like a workout program, commit to beginning and finishing your book or your Audible. I challenge you. And then recognize, have fun with this. Recognize your friends and family, make someone's day, but also recognize the things around you. Recognize the scenery around you as you are working towards climbing your mountain. Recognize your team who's there with you to support you and believe in you. Recognize the people that you're helping, you're bringing along with you. Recognize those amazing things as you are climbing your mountain. Because let me tell you, if you focus on the top of that mountain, it's not going to be so much fun. But if you focus on the people who are there with you and the things around you as you climb that mountain, oh, it's going to be on. And then start now. You can go to the next slide. So maybe your summit, your BHAG is elite or premier or attending the New Leader Conference. Woo! Or helping 3 people a month, or pressing play, starting a program, losing 10 pounds, losing 100 pounds, wearing that dress, whatever your summit is, I challenge you all today, right now, to make the commitment towards walking relentlessly towards your goals. Reach your summit. I guess Kevin's kicking me off the stage. Who's with me? Who is going to reach their summit?